Hello students, today we are going to see 9th standard max 3rd chapter algebra exercise 3.1. Let us see the first question. Which of the following are polynomial? So given expression, we have to check whether it is a polynomial or not. Now first 1 by x squared, it goes into the numerator, we have written as x power minus 2 plus 3x minus 4. So this is the negative integral. Negative integral power. So it is not a polynomial. If it is negative integral power, it is not a polynomial. Next one. X squared into x minus 1. Now we multiply this one, we will get x squared into x cube minus x squared. So this is positive integral power. So it is a polynomial. Next question, 1 by x into x plus 5. Now we have to change into the numerator, x power minus 1 into x plus 5. So now you have to multiply this to x power minus 1 into x power 1 plus 5 into x power minus 1. So here minus 1 plus 1 cancel. So x power 0 plus 5 power x power minus 1. So that is equal to 1 plus 5 x power minus 1. Here also the negative integral integral power is there. So it is not a polynomial. So if it is negative integral power, that is not a polynomial. Can you understand, students? The next question. Write the coefficient of x squared and x in each of the following. First one is 4 plus 2 by 5 x squared minus 3x. What is the coefficient of x squared? This is coefficient. This is x squared term. So you have to write the coefficient, that is the constant term. Whatever it is in the coefficient, whether it is in variable or constant term, anyone, that is coefficient of x squared. So coefficient of x squared is equal to 2 by 5. And what is coefficient of x? Coefficient of x is equal to, this is coefficient of x, that is minus 3. If it is plus, plus. If it is minus, minus 3. Next one, 6 minus 2x squared plus 3x cubed minus root 7x. What is the coefficient of x squared? That is this term. So minus 2. And what is coefficient of x is equal to, this is the x term, so minus root 7. Can you understand? Next one, this pi x squared plus x plus 2. So coefficient of x squared is equal to pi. And what is coefficient of x is equal to, here no terms means you have to write 1x like 1. So coefficient of x is equal to 1. The third question, find the degree of the polynomial. First one is 1 minus root 2 y squared plus y power 7. So see the variables here. Y. What is the first one? Y squared. Here y power 7. Which one is the highest power? 7 is the highest power. So degree is equal to 7. Can you understand? First check whether which one is highest power. That highest power of the variable is the degree. So degree is equal to 7. Now x cube, second question. X cube minus x power 4 plus 6 x power 6 divided by x squared. Now we have to divide each and every one. So x cube by x squared minus x power 4 divided by x squared plus 6 x power 6 divided by x squared. Square term and here 1 cancel and 2 cancel. So here 2, Here 2 cancel means 3. So what is the answer? X power 1 only. So here x square minus x square plus 6x power 3. So what is the highest power of the variable? 3 is the highest power. So what is the degree? Degree is equal to 3. Third question. X cube into x square plus x. Now we multiply this x cube into x square, x power 5, and plus x cube into x, x power 4. So what is the degree? Which one is the highest power for these two variables? 5 is the highest power. So degree is equal to 5. Fourth question. Rewrite the following polynomials into standard form. What is standard form? We have, according to the power, we have to write in the ascending order. That is the standard form. So first one, x minus 9 plus root 7 x cube plus 6 x square. So which one is highest power? According to the power only, you have to write in the ascending order. So root 7 x cube. Next one is square. So plus 6 x square. And then x is there. So plus x minus 9. This is the answer. For second question. Root 2 x square. Minus 7 by 2 x power 4. Minus 7 by 2 x power 4. Plus x. Minus 5 x cube. So according to the power, we have to arrange in ascending order. So that is equal to power 4 is first. So minus 7 by 2 x power 4 and x cube. Minus 5 x cube plus root 2 x squared plus x. No constant term, so no need to write. So third one. 7 x cube. Minus 6 by 5 x square plus 4x minus 1. So 7 x cube minus 6 by 5 x square plus 4x minus 1 as it is, because 3, 2, 1 constant term. So the same answer only. 7 x cube minus 6 by 5 x square plus 4x minus 1 is the answer. The fifth Roman number. Add the polynomial and find the degree. First question. P of x is equal to 6x square minus 7x plus 2. And Q of x is equal to 6x cube minus 7x plus 15. Now we have to add these two. We will get. There is no x cube term here. So you have to write the same. X 6x cube. And what is 6x squared? Plus 6x squared. And 2x terms are there. That is like terms. So minus 7x minus 7x. So we will get minus 7 minus 7. We will get minus 14x. Like terms only you have to add. And what is the constant term for these two terms? 2 plus 15. That is 2 plus 15 is equal to 17. So this is the answer for add of the two polynomials. Adding, we are adding P of x and Q of x. We will get the answer for this. And find the degree of the result of the polynomial. So what is the result? This is the result. Which one is highest power? 3 is the highest power. So what is the degree? Degree of this result is degree is equal to 3. Can you understand? The next question is P of x is equal to 7x cube minus 6x plus 1 and Q of x is equal to 7x square plus 17x minus 9. So now we have to add this to cube term. There is no cube term here. So 7x cube as it is, and square term also only one term in this. So plus 7x square, and two like terms of x, that is minus 6 plus 17. So 17 minus 6 we will get 11x. So plus 11x, and minus 9 plus 1, so minus 8. And what is the degree of this polynomial? Power 3 is the highest power. So degree is equal to 3. Can you understand, students? Okay, students, we will see the next sums in the next class. Thank you for listening. Thank you.